Welcome, it's Raj from 3CB. Cristiano Ronaldo is a massive leaper, reportedly getting as high as 71 centimeters, 28 inches off the ground. However, what goes up must come down. Cristiano's landing technique is arguably even more impressive than his jumping ability, and a key reason for not only his success heading the ball, but his sustained health and longevity, especially considering landing generates an average force of 5 times body weight. This clip highlights his typical landing technique. He comes down unevenly, which isn't ideal, but it happens quite frequently because elite football doesn't always allow for ideals. But he comes down with his ankle pointed downwards, plantar flexed, with his left forefoot, ball of the foot making first contact. The research shows that the specific angle of the ankle at landing significantly varies the amount of landing ground reaction force, GRF. In fact, it may be the most critical variable to reducing or increasing force through the body. To that point, landing with the ankle at 40 degrees of plantar flexion versus landing with 0 degrees of plantar flexion nearly doubles the amount of landing GRF, from 3.24x body weight to 6.5x body weight. Further, as Cristiano's left heel drops to the ground, his left knee is flexed, bent. The research shows that landing with an extended, straight knee, a stiff landing, versus landing with a flexed, bent knee, a soft landing, results in nearly 20% less force absorption by soft tissue and a much larger load on the joints. As Cristiano's right foot touches down, again, his ankle is plantar flexed, pointed down, with his forefoot touching first. And again, the right knee is flexed to absorb force. Additionally, he sits back into his hips rather than overflexing the knee, which allows the big muscles on the backside of the legs, glutes, hamstrings in particular, aka the posterior chain, to absorb force. Lastly, notice how quickly he transitions weight from his left to right leg in the final mini hop out of pure excitement. CR7 is able to maintain that technique even under extreme circumstances like his massive leap versus Sampdoria. He's coming down at an extremely awkward angle, but his left ankle is plantar flexed and the forefoot touches first. As his left heel drops, his left knee flexes. He drops back into the left hip. This requires an incredible amount of neuromuscular control, balance, and strength. As a right leg comes down, again, not to beat a dead horse, but his consistency of landing mechanics is ridiculous. The ankle is plantar flexed with the forefoot touching down first. And the right knee flexes, and he's immediately up again. This is the most impressive landing and consistency of technique I've ever seen.